فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters, I trust that all you guys are in the best of health and iman إن شاء الله تعالى. This is your brother Sa'ad and I'm here with Ustaz Abu Taymiyyah. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Okay, طيب, so inshallah today what we're going to do is I'm just going to pose a question to Ustaz that many people that I see tend to ask, and I don't think there's a good enough answer out there for the people. And inshallah ta'ala we'll, you know, discuss it as well in terms of a solution for that issue that these people have. And the issue is basically this. Many of us, you know, in our lives, we'll go through trials and tribulations from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we don't know how to react to these trials and tribulations. And this includes the practicing brothers and sisters as well, because we know the ayat and the ahadith regarding, you know, trials and tribulations and calamities and why does Allah send these calamities upon us. But when it comes down to being actually afflicted with the calamity, we tend to really act in a negative way, right? And we start questioning, why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do this? What was the reason? Why me? Why did my father have to suffer like this? Why did my child have to go through this? Why did I have to get, you know, all these problems? We start questioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what advice would you give to these people when they get to this point in their life?
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Firstly, we need to understand one thing, that, you know, being in this dunya, this dunya is a darul ibtila. It is a world that one is going to be tested and is going to be trialed. And we can't just expect to sit back on our sofas, put our legs up, and, you know, and not expect any problems and, you know, trials and tribulations to come to us. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla clearly told us that in the Quran, Alif Lam Mim, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Does one think that he's going to be left alone? He's just going to say amanna, يعني I believe. He believes in Allah Azza wa Jal, وهم لا يفتنون, and then he's not going to be trialed. A person, he enters into the religion, he just says I believe. He affirms all of this, you know, the aspects of monotheism, and then after that, nothing's going to come to him. Allah then says, وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. For indeed, we have trialed those before you. فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. And Allah Azza wa Jal will know who those who are truthful are and those who are liars. So one can't just expect to just relax and, you know, and just chill out and nothing to come to him. Trials and problems and tribulations are bound to come to you. Why? Because this is just bound to happen. It's part of life. It is part of you being placed upon the face of this earth.
So, Ustaz, what about this question, right? We all know, okay, we understand that first point, right? That everyone's going to be tested, okay?
Yeah.
You know, there's not a single person that will walk this earth except that he'll be tested. Even the prophets, the Anbiya, they were all tested as well. And they will guarantee Jannah, right? So if they were tested, then we're definitely going to be tested. But how do you come to terms with things like, you know, my son just died?
Mm-hmm.
But it came from Allah. Like how does a person come to terms knowing that his son died, but Allah caused for that to happen, and it's a good thing? Like, how do you understand that?
Okay, good. You know, firstly, Allah Azza wa Jalla also says, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Never is one, or whatever a person is afflicted with, is always from Allah Azza wa Jalla. That without a shadow of a doubt is from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Naam. As to whether it is good or bad, this is what the people always tend to ask. Why is it so good? Yani someone dying. A lot of us are aware of the story of Khidr. The story of Khidr, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dedicated a chapter in Surah Al-Kahf. The kid that Khidr killed. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned in a hadith, وَأَمَّا الْغُلَامَ الَّذِي خَتَلُ خِذَرْ طُبِعَ كَافِرًا وَلَوْ عَاشَ لَأَرْحَقَ أَبَوَيْهِ طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا. The kid that Khidr killed, he was sealed to be a kafir, a disbeliever. Allah Azza wa Jal knew this and he revealed this to Khidr. And had he lived, he would have brought problem, ungratefulness, ungratitude upon his parents. So sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees something that you don't know about. Maybe had that kid lived, had that kid lived. It could have been the reason why you had more bigger and more major problems. And it could have been the reason why he slipped you out of your religion, pulled you away from it, due to him being such a big distraction in your life. You becoming busy from the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved you from all of this. And Allah Azza wa Jalla also said in the Quran, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. And perhaps you might dislike something, but it's good for you. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ أَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He knows, but you don't know. And sometimes you find that there's a great reward in it as well. Let's just say, for example, we've got a car. Three kids in there and a mother. The mother, she's in the car driving. She ends up hitting another car. What happens? Car crash. All three babies die and she's the only one that lives. It looks evil to us. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned Majmu' al-Fatawa, أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَخْلُقُ شَرًا مَحْضًا. There is nothing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created, has decreed that is what? Pure evil. It might look evil to you, but to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has, you know, greatness and other goodness stored for you. And the proof for this is, you know, let's just say, for example, three kids, they die in a car crash. It looks evil to you, sah? But look what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. مَا مِن كُنَّ إِمْرَأَةٌ تُقَدِّمُ ثَلَاثًا مِن وَلَدِهَا إِلَّا كَانَ لَحِجَابًا مِنَ النَّارِ. Never does a woman lose three kids. Three kids die from her. Except that this is now a screen between her and the fire. So a woman, she said, وَثْنَيْنِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. What about اثنين? Two. You know, if I lose two kids, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, two kids. So something evil according to you has just happened, but look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in store for you and the goodness that will come to a person. And you have to understand also, brothers and sisters, that trials and tribulations, the more a person he is connected and he is strong in his religion, he is bound to be tested more and more. The brother Sa'd, he mentioned earlier that the messengers and the prophets, they were tested, and even though they were guaranteed al-Jannah. Likewise, the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim, Allah tells us in the Quran about all of this. There's a hadith the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, أَشَدُّ النَّاسِ إِبْتِلَاءً الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. The most severely tested people are the Anbiya, the Prophets. فَالْأَمْثَلْ فَالْأَمْثَلْ. Then those that are like them, then those that are like them. يُبْتَلُ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَىٰ قَدْرِ دِينِ. A person, he is tested in accordance to his religion. So if a person is very strong upon his religion, very, very strong, constantly prays, constantly fasts, he's most likely to be tested. And the tests, the trials are going to keep on coming to this individual. But if a person is far from him, it's most likely that he might not get the same as this individual. You know, some of the Salaf, they used to get scared if the trials and tribulation never came to them. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, has left them. Because they knew the hadith, like when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا حَبَّ شَخْصًا إِبْتَلَاهُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves an individual, He tests him. That doesn't mean also that, you know, sometimes a guy that is not worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal, he's been bad in his religion and he's forgotten Allah Azza wa Jal, he's left him off, that the trials are not going to come to him. Because there is times that Allah Azza wa Jal will afflict this individual. And Allah Azza wa Jal tells us this also in another verse in the Quran, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. Whatever affliction that you're afflicted with is that which your hands have earned, that which you did with your hands. Allah says also, ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِي النَّاسِ. Fasad, corruption has become, you know, apparent upon the earth and also upon the seas due to what people have done with their hands. And an example of this is that which took place in Yemen and also in other places. The Arab Spring, when the people came out and they revolted, they done something that, wallahi, brothers and sisters, the Sharia does not accept. Opposing and revolting and doing protest against a Muslim rule, even if he is the biggest tyrant in the world. So other people had to suffer. Affliction came onto them. Gas prices, electricity prices became so high. You know? Yani, kids were suffering, other people were suffering. Those who participated in these mudaharat, they were suffering as well. People lost money. Naam. Another hadith tells us, in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَا يُحْرَمُ الرِّزْخُ بِخَطِيئَةٍ يَعْمَلُهُ. a servant, a slave, he is prevented provision. Why? Due to a sin that he does. So sometimes a person is afflicted. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to bring him closer to him. Or Allah azza wa loves this individual because this person is close to his religion. And sometimes it is due to his sins. How do we know? We might not ever know. So it's upon us, when these afflictions come to us, is to constantly go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to repent back to him. Whether we repent due to the first reason or the second reason, there's always khair in it. Because this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves anyway. The Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, "Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahhirin." Allah loves those who constantly make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those who are pure. So a person, he goes back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, runs back to him, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, as Allah says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, and hasten to the forgiveness of your Lord. And Allah says also, فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, hasten to doing good deeds. And the more he does that, the more he's conscious of Allah Azza wa Jalla, the more he's on his toes, and the more likely he is going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while he is in this good state.
Jazakallahu khairan for that. Just the last question, which I think a lot of people might still be asking, is when the affliction occurs upon the individuals, how should they react? Is it through patience, through repentance? Like, what's the key thing that they need to do? And inshallah.
Good. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ, and we will test you now with something of fear and also poverty, وَنَخْسِ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ, and also loss of wealth, وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, and then in the end Allah Azza wa Jalla says, and we will give glad tidings to those who are patient. You know, this characteristic, brothers and sisters, of being patient is something that many people don't have. If only we knew the reward that comes out of patience. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرُهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ, and those who are patient, we will reward them with a reward without any reckoning. So to be patient upon these trials and tribulations, to run back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we previously mentioned, and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dua to keep you patient, because sometimes it's not easy to want to be trialed, maybe, you know, whether it is the death of his parents, and then maybe through a divorce, or maybe he miscarriage or whatever, no, or his kids die. It's not easy. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the verse after that, and people only think that you mention this dua when you're afflicted with a death in your family. Yes, without a doubt, it is a tragedy. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, الَّذِينِ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, those when they are afflicted with an affliction, they say, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. That is general for any affliction. Then Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ, these people, they, Allah Azza wa Jalla will send down upon them blessings and also mercy. وَأُولَٰئِكُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ, these are the people that are guided. So you have in this ayah now, when I'm afflicted with an affliction, what do I do? It is answered in these ayat of Surah Al-Baqarah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about one being tested of fear, poverty, loss of wealth. How does he go about? He says, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, he's patient with himself. And Allah says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, will give glad tidings to this person that is patient. And these people, Allah Azza will send down upon them blessings and mercy, and they are the guided individuals.
Okay, brothers and sisters, I hope that clarified the answer that many of you usually tend to ask, inshallah ta'ala. For those of you that want to study your deen further, but you don't have any means of classes or where to study or how to study, you don't know the first thing about studying Islamic sciences, if that's the case, then Ustad Abu Taymiyyah, Ustad Abdurrahman Hassan, and Ustad Abul Abbas Naveed, they have what is known as Al-Madrasatul Umariyya, a online program where you will learn how to study your deen. If you guys just go to the link in the description below, and you'll find all the information there.